Jesse, yo! What the fuck are you doing?
Muscle confusion, bro. You talk too loud. They're gonna hear you.
What's up, guys? Jeff Cavalier, ATHLEAN-X.com. Muscle confusion in progress, or at least in Jesse's mind, or at the very least, wherever Jesse's training, because it ain't here anymore. He got kicked out for that bullshit. He's confusing every other person in the gym with what he's doing. You see, muscle confusion is one of those buzzwords and terms that I have to dive into here today to get to the truth behind what we're really trying to accomplish, because I actually believe in muscle confusion. I do, I swear. But we have to understand what we're doing in the first place. Confusing muscles should be about one thing and one thing only, and that is progressively overloading your muscles, providing them with a new stimulus that they aren't used to. So we don't have to do acrobatics. We don't have to get on physio balls and start slamming med balls into the wall, because that's downright dangerous. What we have to do is provide some form of stimulus that your muscles haven't encountered until that point if you want to see progression. So you ready? I'm going to give you a great demonstration right here of a possible way to create muscle confusion. All right, here we go. I'm going to count down. 3, 2, 1, bam. There's muscle confusion right there. Let's say I squat at 225, and that's what I'm used to doing all the time. By adding a single 5-pound plate to each side of the bar, I've just gone to 235. Guess what? My muscles are confused. They haven't felt that before. That's something new. I haven't trained with that weight, at least in that rep range. So it's something new. But we can go beyond that. Let me show you another example here of muscle confusion. Let's stick with the same weight that we always use on the same exercise, the squat. And let's get confused. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, boom. I squat, and now I'm confusing myself. But in a good way, because now I'm doing a pause squat. You see, this pause squat is a tempo alteration that my muscles haven't felt before. If you haven't done pause squats before, they're a great way to introduce a new stimulus, i.e. confusion, to your muscles that will demand that they adapt to it and get bigger and stronger and more able to handle that stress in the future. So by adding a pause squat, I have to be in command of the weight. I can't simply rely on momentum down and back up again, or kind of half-ass reps down and up in order to handle that. So, or to achieve that. So now I have to demand that my muscles get used to being down there, and that is in itself a form of confusion. But we can do other things too. We can bring out the new exercises. I'm not saying don't bring out new exercises. I'm all for new exercises, but with a purpose. And this is where it sort of blends into the whole aspect of functional training that we covered here before. What is functional training? It's one and only one thing. It's purposeful training. So if your purpose is to build strength, doing crazy acrobatics should not fit into your training, because they ain't gonna serve a purpose. But if your purpose is to be more athletic, then maybe altering the way that you do certain exercises, instead of just straight, always lunging straight ahead, introducing a three-dimensional lunge, that's a good thing. We're demanding more out of that. Or even this exercise here. This is called a fielder curl. We've actually put this in to some of our programs as a way to get our guys to focus on their hips and their hip training, but in a way that we know we can get them to do it, because guess what? We've included the biceps. There's the magic word. Now all of a sudden people will do it because they've included biceps with it. Sometimes you have to break out those means if you need to get someone to start working on muscles they don't tend to want to work on. But I can tell you this from the ground up, it's an athletic-based movement, and we're gonna start working our hips in the frontal plane, which is a good thing. But the bottom line is this: a form of confusion should always be sought after, because to me, that means that you're looking for some way to challenge your muscles in a way that they're not used to. Confuse them, but don't start looking to gimmicky, stupid, acrobatic exercises, if that's what you want to call them, to create muscle confusion. Because all it's going to do is, like I said, leave everybody else in the gym confused as to what you're actually trying to accomplish in the first place, and probably leave you disappointed in the results that you see. Guys, if you're looking for a program that puts the science back in strength, head to ATHLEAN-X.com right now, and I'll show you how to make the right progressions to always keep the gains coming. Because we know that we can easily plateau, especially if you're drug-free in training. Plateaus are inevitable, but you need to have ways and strategies, whether you're manipulating your volume, your tempo, the exercises that you're doing, you need to have those methods to be able to keep those gains coming. I'm going to show you how to do that over in our program. In the meantime, if you found this video helpful or enlightening, leave your comments and thumbs up below, and I'll make more of what you want to see in the future. All right, guys, I'll see you soon.